Hello guys, today I'm going to show you a tutorial on RMA. RMA, what's RMA? Remote Method Invocation. It allows a program to invoke methods on an object when the object is not located on the same machine as the program. Now let us see how to implement RMA with the help of NetBeans IDE. First, we have to create an interface for a client and server. To implement RMI, we need a client and server. Apart from that, an interface which needs for both client and server. So I'm creating a three separate projects. One is for interface, server and client. First, let us create an interface. Create a new project and I will name it as RMI. Just click finish. Then create a new Java interface RMA. This interface extends the remote. Fix the imports. Okay. Let me have this scenario. The client inputs the name and the server says I plus name. For example, I input my name as Tamil and the server reply me I Tamil. So first we create an interface for that. Void, we need to return it. So public return type string get data parameters string text throws remote exception and that's it. This is the interface needed for both client and the server. Simply build the project. Okay, now let us implement this interface over the server. Create a new project and name it as server. Okay, server. Name it as server. Finish. Now create a new Java file and name it as RMA server. And this RMA server extends initcast remote object. It implements the interface RMA. And we have to add the jar file of the build interface RMI to resolve this error. And that's it. Now implement all the abstract methods. Create a constructor and delete RMI server. Close remote exception. Now let us implement this interface. The idea is to already say that the server is going to say an I, the user. So text is equal to just add a I space text return text. That's it. Now let us create the instance and the registry for our server. Void create a try catch block. Create a registry for the server. Registry base equal to locate registry dot create registry. Enter the port number 1099. 16 ports. Now rebind the server. Let's start with, and let me keep the server name as server. Create the instance of that new RMN server. For a reference, just print on the console that the server has started. I'll send the file. That's first the server started. And server keeps on running. That's it.